Hi all, welcome back to more 7 Days to Die. Hal here, and well, we are making cement. Actually, the cement is being made, we're just kind of waiting for it at this point. Oh, so happy Monday everybody, hope you're having a fantastic day. We are going to be working on a few things here, because we still need to make a bunch of cement. I really haven't done anything more since the last episode, where we were taking a look and building that huge pyramid. So now that we've gotten at least some of that done, we can talk a little bit more about what we're actually doing. Let's go ahead. I need to make a couple of bellows really quick. Oh, how many can I make? I can make 7. How do I mean do I need? Let's just make 5 for now. Okay, so let me grab that stack of stone. There we go. And what we can do is we're gonna head out. You know what? Yeah, let's head out this way. Just because we can. So yeah, basically what we're gonna do today is I'm gonna be working on making a few forges, obviously. And maybe a couple of cooking fires. I haven't decided yet. See, playing too many other games, hitting the wrong buttons here. You should be closing, thank you. You will be closing. And we're gonna head out the front here. Now, once I get the pyramid built, well, or what people are calling the pyramid built, what we're gonna be able to do is to build a tunnel out under all of the water. And it'll just be basically a single, you know, just a single block wide and, you know, 2 blocks tall kind of thing. Just basically to get out here. But we are going to be putting in a forge area, because what we're going to do is we're going to actually move all of our manufacturing over here so that we can get the horde and the heat map out here, because with what we're doing with the ramp system, basically the zombies will be able to come in from any direction and they'll just kind of wander over here and fall in. So now what I am thinking about doing up here on this side is building maybe building a defense tower area, but I'm thinking I just want to have something that I can use basically for mass production. And that's what we're really planning on doing over here in this area. So down here, what we're going to do is we're going to put a couple of forges around the perimeter. And then maybe like one in the middle, just because. But what we're going to have up here is we're going to have the cement posts to support the spikes. And then we'll have more posts going around. I'll show you what we're going to do with it once we have a little bit of cement to work with. I'm just waiting for some to finish up. So what we'll end up with is basically the posts will be here to block any of the zombies from just walking through, and they're just gonna go kind of float. I'm not really worried about the realism of it. And then like I said, we'll have the lines going across with spikes on top. So all right, so once we have all of that said and done, what we will be doing is we will I think this is the side we may do it on. I don't know. I haven't decided yet. But I'm thinking I'm going to continue this stairway. I'm either going to continue it on this side or leave this side as it is and just put storage over here. And then on this side have it go down into a tunnel. Basically just go all the way down the bedrock. And then we'll have the tunnel from here all the way over to the base. Did I just hear zombies, or am I just hearing things? I may just be hearing things. Okay. Oh, nope. See? Zombie horde. We apparently are undetected. Oh, we're hunted. Alright. Some impromptu zombie hunting. What am I being hunted by? Do you see them? I don't see them. Where did they go? Oh, there they are. There's one. There's two. I see a tryhard over there. Let's see if we can get to him. Thought I saw a tryhard over here. Maybe I didn't. Thought I saw one crawling around over there. See, I keep seeing little flashes and it's just the waves. Okay. Well, we'll deal with them if they show up. So where did the other guys get off to? Because we saw a couple. Aha, see there's a bunch of them over there at our base. Is that a zombie over there on the... They were just destroying my house. Come here. Out of the water. Thank you. Look at this stuff. Goofball. I didn't say you could come visit. I think I missed. You gonna stand back up? Come on. Where you at, buddy? You gonna make me come over there to kill you? Okay, let's go kill the zombie. That's it, it's like shooting zombies in a barrel, but, you know, zombies in a barrel would be easier to hit. Okay. Shooting into the new water. See, look at that. That should have been a hit. Yeah, see, the water is weird now. And there you go. Sandwich. We're going to take that simply because of the fact that you can now turn those into moldy bread. And for those who don't know, you can actually harvest moldy bread from the sandwiches. Basically, you take 10 sandwiches, take them over to the chemistry station, drop them in there, and select moldy bread. But yeah, it's kind of expensive because you do have to use 10 sandwiches. But with the rate that they drop, it's not usually too much of a big deal. We are going to go ahead and jump here because I want to see if we can find any more zomzoms. Where, oh, where has our zomzom gone? Lots of zombie corpses. Always good to see. Because it means our defenses are still working. Ow, ow, ow. Off the spike. Oh, bloody rot. Really? You are taking trap damage. It's a trap. Unless you go to Starbucks, then it's a frap. But, you know. Alright. Alright, let's take this out of here. Oh, I keep doing that. Let's... Okay, zombie corpse has been removed. Let's go ahead and take out the other zombie corpse. Alright. And it looks like we've got one more over here. So I have to say the base defenses have been working pretty well. The last horde basically undercut the tower we had up on the hill, so that's why the entire hillside has been armored up. We actually need to do a little bit more work on that. Show you what we got going on over here since we're here. So what we're going to do, hey puppy, what we're going to do is we're going to continue with the regular ramps around here. We're going to do the turn the corner with them basically. And that'll just be to cover all of this to keep them from digging under. And because we have them set with ramps, excuse me, Frog in the throat. So, but since we have it set with ramps, what'll happen is they'll actually walk up here, and it looks like... Now, see, I just repaired a bunch of this stuff. Man, we must be having just random hordes spawning at night or something, and I'm not hearing them. So, but yeah, basically what happens is because it's ramped, they come up here, and they'll walk through the spikes and continue on their way. So that's the idea, at least. Also, we'll keep them from destroying and digging into the hillside, which is good for us, bad for them. Because digging into the hillside is good for them and bad for us. So, now, I am thinking about taking this out on level and putting in... So basically, we would have this one block row here and then another block next to it. So you'd have just a small block path to walk, and then we'd have another wall of blocks here. Again, it's just to slow them down from digging into the hillside a little bit, and basically protecting our area a little bit better. Alright, so, go ahead, go see if we've got some cement. So what I'm going to do is I am going to go check our cement production, see what we've got going on. If we've got some, I will bring you all back. If not, then I will wait for some to be finished. See y'all shortly. And we're back. Alright, so what we were talking about doing is, let's go ahead and bring this up. I'm going to move these out of here. And where'd they go? There they go. So what we made are the concrete poles. Now, a lot of people will use the pillar 50s because you can, you know, reach between them and everything. You can do that with these as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to go like so. Go one, two, three. So basically what we're going to do is we're going to take these and continue them straight across. And we're going to do the same thing on the edges here so that we can kill the zombies. You know, if we're standing here, we can kill them. But more importantly, it's so that we can loot without losing any of our supplies. And this will allow us to do is we can actually repair the spikes that'll be up here from underneath. So I need to make, how many is that? That's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so 25, so 22 more. Let's go ahead and get those crafting. They're a quick craft, so it shouldn't be too bad. There we go. And then we're going to make another 10, 20. So 10 and 10, so 40 more. Oh, not 167. There we go. Alright, so now we're just going to keep repeating this process here. Alright. And the nice thing is that because we're putting them flush with this surface, that it leaves these blocks open. So if we really want it to, we could put it on that block, but I don't want to do that because it still does basically block being able to put the spikes in here. And if we put them on this side, we'll still be able to walk through here. So, like I said, it really is more of a just to have it here thing than anything else. Alright, so we're gonna go here, here, like a so. Now, if you wanted to, you could also start them so that these were towards this face. One of the things that I had thought about doing was actually starting them so that this one was as it is, and then this one would be the reverse of that one, so that it would actually be on this other corner here. And then in the middle, you'd basically have a double up. But I didn't want to do that because it sometimes does weird things. So, but all we need this for is that. And now, the reason why you would normally use pillar 50s in this situation is that because when the spikes break, you're going to be able to pass through here. With a pillar 50, you wouldn't be able to do that. Which is why we're going to upgrade those spikes as much as possible. And then the stuff down here, we're going to have down in the lower area, we're basically going to have iron bars around the outer edge. And that's one of the reasons why we're putting the forges on the outer edge. So, because we don't want things breaking. Because they will be able to fall through here, so we do need to be careful about that. And then for here, we're going to go like that, just to make sure. Yes, we can still get through here. Okay. And like I said, I am not that worried about it being a floating design because, well, I'm not really that worried about the realism factor. But just for the folks who are, there we go. And you are going to go here. There you go. See? Nice and easy, right? Okay. So we'll put this one here. Put one on top of it. I know, I just said I wasn't going to do that too, didn't I? There you go. And then what we can do from here is we're going to do this one's on the back wall, so go there, there. And then you can use the same style of design for your normal bases as well. Did we not make enough? Okay, so it's because I missed because of the so I need to make another 8. See, trying to make it look nice. There we go. So you can use these for other single entrance areas or single block sized holes. Because of the way that it works, you're able to, if this was a full block here below it, which I had thought about doing, honestly, but if it was a full block here, basically crawlers would still be able to get through here because it's a single block high. Putting just this little bar here keeps the crawlers out. It's weird how it works. Not everything in 7 Days to Die makes sense, but that's okay. There we go. And now what we do from here is, how much do we have left? Oh, we got plenty. So that means we can then do up to reinforced. And I'll probably come back once all of this is dry and we've got enough metal to do so. I'll probably upgrade this to the steel as well. If I can get enough of it, I will also upgrade it to the stainless steel. That way we don't have to worry quite so much about things getting through all the time. But we want to make sure all of this is done, so that it is as strong as possible. So yeah, this is the idea, right? There. So we do this, and then to go down here. We are getting this stuff done. So hopefully we should be in a good position to use this for the next Horde Night as well. And it'll be a little bit more entertaining and interesting for you, hopefully. Because I have a feeling that no matter what I do, the zombies are going to break something and get through and eat my face. So, you know, at least it'll be entertaining, right? So there you go. Now the only thing I need to do is put the metal spikes on top of it and start upgrading everything. So, yeah. Now I need to remember not to fall in there, because I don't have a way out of there if I do fall in. So I'll have to break a spike and drop down through. All right, so we've got that going. I think we're gonna go ahead and call this one here. About the only thing I really have left to do is upgrading some of the stuff over here. So I'm gonna go ahead and do this, but I don't need y'all here for it. Well, I mean, if you want to hang around, you're more than welcome to, but what is it they always say at the bars? You don't have to go home, but you can't stay here, so. Anyway, I hope you all enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you hit that like button. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to throw them into the section down below each of the videos. I do my best to get back to you, and if I miss you, I apologize. Nothing personal, just out of time. So, anyway, I'm out of here. If you're new to the channel, I do ask that you also subscribe. Not only will it keep you up to date with what's going on around here, it's quite possibly the easiest way to let me know that you're enjoying the content, and it also helps the channel to grow. All good things all around, so yeah, it's also free, so you know, never hurts, right? Let's see here. Go ahead and get that and get that. We are good there. And I think that is almost it for this side. I just need to fill in the last few pieces, and this wall is done. So, I'm out of here. Hope you all have a fantastic day. Thanks again for stopping in, and yeah, we'll see you back here next time for more 7 Days to Die. As always, folks, take care and be safe out there, everybody. Okay, so we need to make one, two... What is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of those. Alright. Oh no, we just need these, so we need to make a crap ton of those. Okay. And then... Alright, so let's go ahead and do that, and we will get the stuff going.